the color a surprise to you?
Just the fact that we could tell what the color was very surprising, and it's very exciting. It's something that we thought we might never know about anything that's been dead as long as 120 million years, like this Sinosauropteryx.
And does it teach us anything about the colors of other dinosaurs?
Not yet, but it gives us hope that we may be able to tell, again, like you saw in the piece, might be able to identify certain colors in certain dinosaurs. It requires a very special type of preservation, but it is very exciting, and it is something that we thought we might never know.
Do you think potentially you could work out, for example, what color a Tyrannosaurus rex was, and that would absolutely shock the entire world because we're used to them being gray?
It's always possible. It does require the animal to fall into a deep pool of water without any oxygen in it, and that's the kind of preservational environment that we need to get this. So if you can get a Tyrannosaurus at the bottom of a bog, you can certainly figure it out.
I'm sure.
The other thing we need to remember is that we always the other thing that is that we think of these animals as being gray or brown like modern mammals, but they probably had color vision because a lot of modern reptiles have color vision. So stripes aren't that surprising. It's kind of neat to find out for sure in this animal, but you can imagine Tyrannosaurus rex virtually any color.
Yeah, I'm sure there's one out there that we're going to discover. But as Jane was saying, the serious point to this is actually it tells us something about the fact that lots of these creatures had feathers. And that tells us something about the way they lived, right?
Exactly. And as you saw in the piece, these feathers appeared long before flight, as far as we can tell, or at least in animals that certainly couldn't have flown. Feathers appeared well before these animals were flying, so they may have been for insulation, they may have been for display. It's probably true that they were for a combination of things. Maybe they were for display and for insulation.
Are all of these things somehow building a bigger picture for us about what happened through evolution? Are these gaps being filled in? Tell us where we are right now.
Of course, certainly they are. You hear the word missing link thrown around quite a bit. And virtually any organism that you find in the fossil record is a link between one thing and another. For instance, these animals that we're talking about with the color, they are helping us to flesh out exactly how birds became birds. You saw a few weeks ago there was some discovery of fossil footprints of the earliest animals that with backbones that walked around on land. These things just help refine existing theories and offer their own new insights. We're constantly being surprised, and there will be no end to discovery. I mean, there's no end in sight.